Thank you, Mr. Chairman, sir, for allowing me to speak on demand for grants of Ministry of Agriculture. Honorable Finance Minister claimed that major focus is given on agriculture economy and farmer welfare. But on one hand, we see farmers commit suicide every day. There is an increase of farmer suicide since last year. Even the Supreme Court has stepped in and sought central government why it has not framed any policy on this. It claims for allowing an agricultural credit of rupees 10 crore and the allocation of rupees 9,000 crore for the Fasal Bima Yojana. Likewise, announcement of soil health cards, model law on contact farming, allocation of rupees 8,000 crore for dairy processing fund and increasing the national agriculture market from 250 to 500. Increasing the funding for the rural and agriculture sector by 24% in the fiscal year 2017-18 to rupees 1.87 trillion. All this would find reason and help the farmers only when they are providing with loans at low rate of interest from the banks, and at the times of the floods and droughts, waves of the farmers should be loans of the farmers should be waived off. Unless you help the farmer to come out of the tentacles of the suicide, there is no point of selling out doing this or that. For example, see the news items of the statement dated 7 March 2017. Farm districts in Maharashtra claimed 3,052 lives in 2016. This is the figure of the just 1 year, 2016, which means more than 8 farmers committed suicide every day of the year, that too in just one state. What about the other states? Since the figure of NPAs of public sector bank, it is soaring every day, rupees 6.8 lakh crore, 70% of them are big corporate houses. This government has not hesitation to take measures to check the ever-rising NPAs of the bank, but think innumerable times to waive up the loans of the farmers due to which they are committing suicide. Farmers are the backbone of our economy and our country. So the Honorable Finance Minister bringing more regulated market to the electronic national regulated market platform. Is the country ready, or the farmer community ready, or the rural area ready for such an electronic platform? Sir, another ambitious announcements bringing 1 crore households out of poverty and 50,000 villages make poverty free. How many households in the farming communities were brought out of poverty, and how many gram panchayats are made poverty free? How much emphasis has been paid by the ministry on agriculture farming technologies and reducing the impact of climate change? As per the report of the doubling farmers' income by 2022 issued by the Indian Council for Agriculture Research, the average monthly income of a person from farming increased from rupees 1,060 in 2003 to rupees 3,844 in 2013, which means income of farmers got compounded annually only at a growth rate of 13.7%. When facts speak in this fashion, how would the government dream of doubling the farmers' income by 2019? Sir, amount allocated for research and education of agriculture is rupees 6,800 crore only, which is way below 1% of agri GDP. That needs to be allocated to revitalize our agriculture with new seeds and innovations. It is reported in the Times of India dated 2nd February 2017 that in comparison, just one seed company, Monsanto, spends almost 70% more resources for research and development of seeds and chemicals than the entire ICAR system in India. It looks completely out of sync, the allocations made by the... Sir, I'm concluding just now, 1 minute. On research and education of agriculture. Lastly, I will conclude. I was saying the potato growers in West Bengal and in some other state are facing difficulties as their produce is sold at half the price, with the result they are incurring huge losses. They are not deriving any profit in spite of toiling in the farm to grow potatoes. There is an urgent need to provide subsidy to the potato growers as the central government extends subsidy to the rice growers. Thank you very much, sir.
Shrimati P.